Thank you, Luann. Good morning and welcome to Grace Presbyterian. I'm Julie Stouse and I am the liturgist this morning. Neil is off taking a little time after all the busyness of the holidays. So we're welcoming Claire Schlegel this morning as our guest pastor who will be sharing the word of the Lord this morning with us. Thank you for being here, Claire. So let us prepare our hearts and our minds for worship.
Good morning, everyone. As we reflect on 2023 and look forward to 2024, we think back to the triumphs and tragedies of the past 12 months, and we keep in mind that no matter what happens, God is always in charge. Back in October of 1962, during the Cuban Missile Crisis, which went on for 13 days, much of the world was in fear at the time. It was really the worst time of the Cold War that the U.S. had encountered. And during that period of time, there was an American composer and her husband, a French composer and songwriter, that composed a Christmas song encouraging folks to feel encouraged, if you will, and try to appease the world and make folks feel that much better during that time of crisis. And we're about to sing that song. It became very popular during the 1960s. Many of the famous singers sang it at the time. And so Ann and I would like to sing that for you this morning. Said the night wind to the little lamb, "See what I see. Way up in the sky, little lamb. Do you see what I see? A star, dancing in the night with a tail as big as a kite. With a tail as big as a kite." Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy, "Do you hear what I hear? Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear?
A song. A song high above the tree with a voice as big as the sea. With a voice as big as the sea."
Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king, "Do you know what I know?
Do you know what I no.
In your palace, warm, mighty king, do you know what I know?
Do you know what I know?
A child shivers in the cold. Let us bring him silver and gold. Let us bring him silver. Said the king to the people everywhere, "Listen to what I say.
Listen to what I say.
Pray for peace, people everywhere.
Listen to what I say.
Listen to what I say.
The child sleeping in the night.
Please stand and join me in the call to worship. When God began to create the heavens and the earth was complete chaos, and darkness covered the face of the deep. At the same time, a rushing wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light, and the light and darkness were distinct. And God called them good. God named the light day, and the darkness night. There was evening, and there was morning, the first day. Swept in by the breath of God, we gather in the goodness of this moment to worship the Creator.
Something here in this bag, so I wanted to show it to you. All right, so I have this plant. Do you happen to know what this plant is called? No? Do any of you know what it's called?
Green.
Yes, it's one of my green plants. I didn't bring any brown ones today. It's actually called a donkey tail. Yes, and when I was growing up, a little girl, my grandmother had one of these, and it was magnificent. This is working toward magnificence. It hasn't quite gotten there. It's a very young plant. But what I noticed is it's also very fragile. And when I was putting it in the bag, a little branch broke off, and all these tiny little leaves, I think they call them leaves, even though it's a succulent. So see all these little individual things? They all kind of broke off because it's a very fragile plant. Kind of like us, we're kind of fragile too, aren't we? Sometimes things can go wrong in our lives. Sometimes things can go wrong in our bodies and in our relationships, and we get our feelings hurt or things don't go the way we want. See, you want one? Can take one. No, it's not gonna do anything. I know, I should have introduced myself. My name is Pastor Claire. You're like, who is this lady? I'm sorry, I forgot to introduce myself. Anyway, I'm filling in for Pastor Neil. Anyway, did you know, though, that even though these little things broke off, and we would say maybe they're broken, that if you put them on a piece of dirt, if you put them in a just lay them on top and squirt them with water, they will grow a new plant. So they begin again. So that's kind of what we're going to be talking about today. We're going to be talking about new beginnings because it's a new year, right? And so maybe some new things are going to happen in this new year. Just like if I ever get around to planting those tiny little leaves, I might be able to get a new plant. Okay, so I'm going to say a prayer for us, and then I think you can go off to your Sunday school activities, okay? All right. Lord God, we give you thanks that no matter what, we can always start anew. We can always have something new going on in our lives, something fresh. And we thank you because you created us, and you created us that way. And so today we just offer you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Hey there. How you doing?
Thank you, Pastor Claire. Please stand and join me as we confess our sins to the Almighty. Lord God of all creation, we come to you from our storm-tossed lives to seek your peace. We come to you with our questions and uncertainties, our worries and anxieties. And we come to you from our joy and our happiness. Each of these emotions are a kaleidoscope of our feelings in life's changing patterns. We come to you knowing that sometimes we have received your grace in vain. We have not relied on your word or wisdom. We have not shown concern or compassion when we should have. We have not loved our neighbor as we love ourselves. We have remained silent when we should have spoken, and spoken when we should have been silent. We ask you from our chaotic and discordant lives for yet another chance to receive your forgiveness. May the mark of that forgiveness be your grace in us as we respond with grace and gratitude your love, and that through that grace, others may glimpse the life of your Son. Amen.
He is exalted, the King is exalted on high. I will praise him, he is exalted, forever exalted, and I will praise his name. He is the Lord, forever his truth shall reign. Heaven and earth rejoice in his holy name. He is exalted. Is exalted on high. He is exalted, the King is exalted on high. I will praise him. He is exalted forever, exalted. Holy. is exalted, the King is exalted on high. He is exalted, the King is exalted on high.
Now we take a moment to pass the peace with one another.
Thank you.
So the news of the family, our prayer concerns, that you know some of them from the bulletin. We pray for Sherry Beckett, who is in our choir, who has pneumonia. So we pray for the healing of her body. We pray for Olivia Kramer, who is here this morning, who had her appendix out a few days ago. Quick healing for a youngin' like that. We're glad you're here, sweetie. We pray for Hazel Crowder, who is battling with COVID, and others that are struck down with illnesses at this time of year, all the coughs that are going around and everything, so that we pray that God will surround those, give healing to those who are in need, and comfort for those who are struggling with grief at this time also. We pray for Neil as he rests. Hello, Neil. Has a time of respite. So we will move along now as Pastor Claire will speak.
So you might have noticed that I'm wearing a Christmas stole because it's still Christmas. It ends this week with January 6th with Epiphany, and we are moving into a new year. And as we do, we are reminded through the mystery of the incarnation that we go into the new year not alone. God is with us, and so we give thanks for that. Please pray with me. By your grace, dear Lord, you've given us this new year. We give you thanks for more time to enjoy your goodness, more time to serve you, another year to show forth your glory, that all may see your light shine through us and might come to faith in your lordship and membership in your kingdom. Continue, Lord, to make all things new, even us. We move into a new year with fears about the future. Give us faith that we venture into a new year led by you, and that you will give us all we need to faithfully serve you and courageously follow you where you lead us. We pray for those who were mentioned today and those on our hearts and minds who have something in front of them, something that is challenging to them. And so we pray for them and lift them up, knowing that you are walking alongside. We pray for your church, that you would bless your church, set today amid all of the challenges around the world, and give us what we need to meet those. Fill this congregation with renewed vitality for the tasks that are set before them. Give us, we are bold to pray, wisdom and grace and courage equal to the assignments that you will give us during the coming year. Help us to have half as much faith in ourselves and our discipleship as you have placed in us by calling us to be your disciples. For all that has been, we give thanks. For all that is to be, we give you our determination to be faithful to you in the new year, as you have been to us in the past. Amen. And now we are bold to say the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
A newborn king to see, pa-rum-pa-bum-pa. Our finest gifts we bring. Pa-rum-pa-bum-bum, rum-pa-bum-bum, rum-pa-bum-bum. Peace on earth, can it be? Years from now, perhaps we'll see.
Our finest gifts we bring from rolling. See the fine young king, rum-pa-bum-bum, rum-pa-bum-bum, rum-pa-bum-bum.
Live in peace again.
So rum-pa-bum-bum.
Every child must be made aware. Every child must be made to care enough for his fellow man, to give all the love that he can. Pray my wish will come true,
I
for my child and your child too. See the days of glory.
I play my bass for you.
Live in peace again.
As he smiled at me,
can it be?
The scripture reading this morning is Genesis 1, verses 1 through 5. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw that the light was good, and he separated the light from the darkness. And he called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. It's the word of the Lord.
So I just realized that when I gave my scripture verse this week, I did not mention what version I was going to be using. And so the version that I have crafted this entire sermon around is not the version that is up there. And so I'm going to read a different version for you. And it's a little bit different. And so see if you notice some of the differences. This is from the NRSV UE, which is a new edited version of the NRSV, New Revised Standard Edition. When God began to create the heavens and the earth was complete chaos, and darkness covered the face of the deep. While a wind from God swept over the face of the waters, then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light, and God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. Did you notice a few differences in that version? That's good, because otherwise I'm going to have to really pinch hit a little bit here. All right, so note to self, make sure you tell the church you're preaching at the version that you're preaching from. Anyway, good morning. I am Pastor Claire Schlegel. I live in Riverside, just up the road. I was a pastor at Magnolia Presbyterian Church there in Riverside for the last 12 years, and I recently retired in May. So I'm very honored and privileged to be here today, and I'm thankful for Neil for inviting me. So, how was your all's Christmas? Did you have a good Christmas? All right. I had a very busy Christmas, and I don't know what I was thinking. I thought that somehow when I retired, that this Christmas was going to be so much easier, and I was going to get all the things done. And those of you that are retired probably can relate to this. It is not what I expected. I am so busy. Oh, my goodness. So I really thought that I was going to have this less chaotic holiday season. I was because I wasn't pastoring a church, I was going to have time to do all the baking I usually don't get to do, and I was going to send out Christmas cards. Oh, that's a good one. I thought, oh, I'm going to get all of my Christmas villages up, and, you know, it's just going to be awesome. So you might guess what happened. A lot of that didn't happen. The only thing that I was able to change is I wasn't up till 2 a.m. wrapping presents. I finished at noon, which is only about 14 hours difference, but it was better than 2 a.m. So I'm at least grateful for that. So now we have this new year right in front of us. And of course, the question always becomes, did you make or are you going to make any New Year's resolutions? How many of you remember if you made New Year's resolutions last year? Did you? Not one person here made a New Year's. Did you not? Is it because you don't remember that you made? Or you don't remember what the resolution was. Whether we have done that or are going to do that, we do like this idea of having a fresh start, don't we? Sometimes fresh starts, when they're our idea, are great. Fresh starts are not always so fun when they're not our idea. But as we think about what might be in store for us in this upcoming year, whether it's improved health or better finances or finally cleaning out the garage, our brief passage has something to say to us today. So we're going to look at that a little bit closer. Before we delve into our text, I just want to mention to you, in case you don't know, that all ancient peoples had a creation story. We always want to know, where did we come from? How did this all begin? And the ancient peoples were not any different. There are all kinds of creation stories. And the Hebrews were no different. They wanted to think about where it all began. How did it all begin? And where did they come from? So in my version, it says, it starts out, when God began to create the heavens and the earth. It just starts off, doesn't it? There's not like an introduction or a preamble. It just says, bam, when God began to create. And you notice, I'm saying when God began to create, and the version that was up there today and the version that probably most of us are really familiar with growing up with was, in the beginning God created the earth, right? And if you think about it, it was a past tense, right? This is what God did once upon a time. He did this a long time ago. There was this finality about it. God did it, it's done, bam. But when you look at the actual Hebrew, there isn't this finality about it. The Hebrew talks about it being this continuous thing. God continues to create. He's not done creating. He's never done creating. So John Goldengay was one of my professors at Fuller Seminary, and he wrote a commentary on the book of Genesis, and he says, creation is not just a once and for all past event. We speak of God and us as being creative in envisaging and shaping new possibilities where there might not have seemed to be any. So you might have seen on the internet or, I don't know, TikTok or something, that this idea that every 7 years all the cells in our bodies are replaced, and that, and then there became this idea that every 7 years we're new people. Gotta tell you, that's not true. There's nothing special about this 7 year cycle. So if you were looking forward to that, sorry. But cells are dying and being replaced all the time. And it's not clear how this idea of this 7 year cycle started, but probably some non-math person just added up all the lifespans of the various cells in our bodies and figured out some kind of formula. But the fact is that the cells in our bodies regenerate at different rates. Red blood cells live for about 4 months. White blood cells live on average of more than a year. Skin cells about 2 or 3 weeks. Colon cells have it rough. They die in about 4 days. Brain cells, though, typically last an entire lifetime. They're not replaced when they die. So, another reason to keep doing that Wordle. I like this idea, though, that I don't have to wait 7 years to be this new person. That I like the idea that we are being continuously renewed or recreated. And if we think about the earth and the cosmos, I think a case can be made for that also being regenerated continuously. The problem becomes is when human interaction outpaces that renewal. So the next verse in my version says, the earth was complete chaos. What comes to mind when you think about chaos? My house looked like chaos after Christmas morning. I'm not sure about yours. My garage is complete chaos at the moment, which is not entirely true because it's been in chaos for the last 10 years. The version, though, that we had today was actually closer to the Hebrew. It said that the earth was, I can't remember, but it was something about it being formless and void, wasn't it? That the earth was formless and void. And there are many other translations that use that same idea. They were without shape or form, or they were formless and empty, which is closer to the literal meaning, again. And again, Goldengay says, there was no chaos before creation, just unformed raw material. That's an interesting phrase, isn't it? Are you unformed raw material? When we approach God, do we approach God as unformed raw material, allowing God to do what God wants to do in our lives or with us? Over that unformed raw material was a darkness that covered the deep. I'm not sure if any of you have ever experienced utter darkness or total darkness. I can remember going on a cave tour in Sequoia National Park, and that we hiked down into the center of this cave, and then they turned off all the lights. It was as dark could be. You literally could not see anything in front of your face, nothing. It was the most darkness I have ever experienced. And it was very unnerving. And then the tour guide lit one match, and the entire cave was bathed in light from just that one small match. I can still remember this physical sense of relief that came over me. Light, it's a powerful thing. And so God spoke over this empty, formless, dark void and said, "Let there be light," and there was light, and God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness and called light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening and morning that first day. When we think about light, we remember the first chapter in the Gospel of John, don't we? He talks about Jesus being that light. Jesus embodied that light. So if you notice, God didn't do away with the darkness. It's not light all the time. God reined it in. He gave it purpose. He used it to his purpose. And our verses say, a wind from God. In the verse up there, it said, the Spirit from God swept over the waters. The word, Hebrew word here, ruach, which Pastor Neil might have talked about some other time, can mean wind or breath or spirit. And so God breathed life. God began to create, to bring life. So when you think back on just these five simple verses, there's a lot in there, isn't there? It's a lot in those just five little verses. And I honestly, when I chose this passage, I wasn't quite sure where it was all going to play out either. That's always what happens when you craft a sermon. Anybody who's written a story knows it's like that too. You have this genesis of an idea, but you're not quite sure where the story's going to go. So, what does this all mean? And what is it saying to each of us today? What is this passage saying about God and who God is? I think the first thing it's saying is that God is creative. In fact, the ultimate creator, continuously creating. Second, I think it's saying all creation, including us, is subject to God because we are the creature. We are the creation. We are not the creator, the creator. I think this passage shows us that God is a God of order, and that God is light, whether physically or spiritually. God brings light in the corners and areas of our lives that need illuminating, that need healing, whether physical or spiritual or emotional or mental. All of those things, God sheds light into that. Might not necessarily take away that, whatever is going on. But God speaks into it and gives us light and power and strength to go through what we go through. So, how does all of this speak into our lives as we approach this new year? Maybe a new diagnosis or a new transition coming up, like retirement. Or how does it speak into a broken relationship that we might have? Or an old hurt that we might be carrying? How does it speak into what's going on in the world around us with the wars in Ukraine and Israel? Or, God help us, a new election year? How does God speak into not only what is going on in our lives, but speak into any other event that threatens us from having this full, life-giving, love-filled life that God intends for each one of us? I don't know what's on your hearts today. I don't know you guys, but we all do have common humanity that we share, common hurts, common challenges, common struggles. I don't know what's going on with you, but God does. And so as you go into this new year, I'm going to invite you to set aside some quiet time. Maybe that's the only New Year's resolution you have to have, is to set aside some quiet time to just listen. Not speak, because God already knows what's on your heart, but to just listen, and listen for God to speak to you. What new thing is God saying to you? What new thing is God raising up in you? Please pray with me. Almighty God, your Spirit swept over the waters of creation, and you are sweeping over us now, creating something new. Call us away from the distractions of the world to experience what you are doing now in us and through us and in our world. Open us to a new awakening, a new beginning, where we look through the lens of the goodness of your creation, experiencing all possibilities in you. Turn us away from the negative lens and lead us to the light. In the name of Jesus, who leads us into life, we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
as you go forth today and into this new year, I pray that the light of God is going to illumine something in your life, that you will take time to listen, and that God will speak into your life and teach you something new so that you can go out and share that light with others. And so as you go forth, may the peace of God, which passes understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ. And may the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon each one of you and remain with you this day and always. Amen.